हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे राम 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 हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे राम 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 हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे राम 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 हरे। नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्ण प्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते राधानाथ स्वामिनिति नामिने। नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्ण प्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने। नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्ण प्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने। ओम ज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितमेन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदांतिकं। वंदेहं श्री गुरु श्रीयुत पदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं सागरजातं सखगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजन सहितं कृष्ण चैतन्य देवं श्री राधा कृष्ण पादान सखगण ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश्च। हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगत्पदे गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसूते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये। वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्येव च पतितानां पावने वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। ईश्वरा परम कृष्णा सच्चिदानंद विग्रह अनादिरादिर गोविंदा सर्वकारण कारणम। हरे कृष्ण। बाय द कॉसलेस मर्सी ऑफ द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉडहेड श्री कृष्णा वी आर नाइसली प्रोग्रेसिंग इन भगवद गीता। बाय कृष्णास कॉसलेस मर्सी वी हैव फिनिश्ड 26 श्लोकास इन द 13th चैप्टर ऑफ भगवद गीता। There is nature, the enjoyer, and consciousness. So in this chapter, Krishna is teaching us about, because Arjuna asked the questions. Arjuna asked the questions about the kshetra, kshetrajna, jnana, jnaya, prakriti, purusha. Everything Krishna is teaching us very clearly. If you just understand the answers for all Arjuna's questions, we understand everything. So that means this is just like preparing for exam. Normally when you prepare for exams, you need to understand what kind of questions will come first of all. You need to expect what kind of questions they will ask, then prepare for them. So then only we can actually do good in the exams. Whenever we prepare for some exams, any exams, so in all the exams, of course, they are going to ask questions. So if you understand the questions, first of all, we need to understand the questions. And then understand the answers. So then we will do very well in the exams. So here Arjuna has asked so many questions in Bhagavad Gita. Very highly technical questions. And highly very much important questions. And everything needed in our life to understand. For us to understand actually. So that we know everything about our life. We know completely. All things about our life we will completely understand. If we just understand all the questions asked by Arjuna and all the answers given by Krishna. So that means we understand everything. So that means if we write an exam on this Bhagavad Gita, if all the questions are asked, what are the questions Arjuna asked? All the questions are asked. We should be able to answer them. So we should prepare Bhagavad Gita in such a way. First of all, we need to understand the question and answer the question. When Arjuna asks the question, by what one is impelled to sinful acts unwillingly as if engaged by force? So that is a question Arjuna asked. So immediately we should be able to answer the question. Atakena prayuktoyam papam charati purushaga anichyanapi varsnaya baladiva niyojita. When Arjuna asks the question, sanyasam karmanam krishna punaryogam cha samsasi yachreya yetayor ekam tanme bruhi sunishchita. You spoke about sannyasa and karma yoga. You tell me which is good for me. So then we should be able to answer the question. When Arjuna asked the question, एवं सततयुक्ताये भक्तास्त्वां परियुपासते ये चापि अक्षरम अव्यक्तम तेषां के योग वित्तम. सो देन वी शुड बी एबल टू आंसर द क्वेश्चन. सो विच इज द बेस्ट वे टू वर्शिप, वर्शिपिंग यू एज ए पर्सन आर वर्शिपिंग यू इन युअर इम्पर्सनल अनमेनिफेस्टेड फीचर, विच वन इज द बेस्ट. We should be able to answer the question. So like that, there are many, many questions. This is just few examples I have given. So the entire Bhagavad Gita is, Arjuna is asking all kinds of questions which are very much needed for us. And at the end, when Krishna asked Arjuna, do you understand, Arjuna, did you hear very attentively and did you understand everything? Do you have any other questions? So that's what Krishna asked. Kachiteta chrutam pata tvayekagrena chetasa कच्चित् अज्ञान सम्मोहः प्रणस्तस्ते धनंजय. सो डिड यू हियर वेरी अटेंटिवली कच्चित् एतत् श्रुतं पात त्वय एकाग्रेण चेतस. एकाग्र मीन्स विथ अनडिवाइडेड अटेंशन. सो दिस वाज विथ सिंगल फोकस्ड अटेंशन. सो देयर सम वी शुड आल्सो लिसन, वी शुड आल्सो हियर दिस भगवद गीता विथ फुल अटेंशन विथ कंप्लीट फोकस. दैट्स व्हाट वी आर डूइंग बाय कृष्णास मर्सी. We are able to study Bhagavad Gita in the same way. Arjuna got this knowledge from Krishna. Now also we are getting the same knowledge from Krishna. So this Bhagavad Gita, always Krishna is speaking. Always Krishna is giving this knowledge. Anyone who goes and takes and reads this Bhagavad Gita, so immediately Krishna starts speaking. In fact, Krishna starts singing. So this Bhagavad Gita is the song of God. So that way we are getting the same knowledge. Only thing, only the difference is that we are not asking the question to Krishna. That's it. So in a class, for example, if there are many students in a class, maybe one student asks the question, all the other students will get benefited. So like that, here Arjuna is the best student and he asked all the questions and we are all getting benefited. That's what is happening with us. So we are getting the knowledge, Arjuna asks questions, and we are all studying Bhagavad Gita. So these days also, because of this pandemic, also things many times, not many times, almost last 1 year, many colleges, they are teaching online. And sometimes the teachers or professors, they record and then they just upload it for the students to listen and then prepare for the exams. So like that, we should consider this Bhagavad Gita is recorded. That's it. So it's recorded and available for us. So that way, Krishna already taught this Bhagavad Gita for us 5,000 years ago. So it has been recorded at that time itself. Vyasadeva recorded. Lord Vyasa recorded everything. And then he is actually giving this knowledge to us. Krishna, it's available to us, this Bhagavad Gita, exactly the same way. So on our behalf, Arjuna asked all the questions. And Krishna answered all the answers in full detail actually. So what we are supposed to do is that this is a course for us. This is a course we should study. And we should definitely get A grade. Here there is nothing like A, B, C, D grades and all there. It's only A grade. Only pass or fail, that's it. We have to pass. So anyone who has faith on this Bhagavad Gita, who is any student who is sincere, is going to pass. Who has faith? Who has faith on this Bhagavad Gita will pass because he will get the knowledge. Because this Bhagavad Gita knowledge, he will receive it. So then he will pass it. So Shraddhavan Labhate Jnanam, that's it. If we have the faith, we will get this knowledge and then we will pass this exam. So that means at the time of our death, if we pass this exam, so then we don't have to come again and take birth in this material world. So if we pass, but when we attend some courses, study some grades, and if you don't pass, what they do, they will fail it. So when they fail, you need to rewrite. You need to write the exam again. You need to prepare and write it again. So like that for us, at least for the devotees, if they are not able to pass, so they will again get a chance to write again until we pass. But for those who don't go to school at all, those who don't go study at all, so they will never be able to write the exam at all. So they will never pass and they will always be struggling in this world. So for us, we are very fortunate. We are putting that efforts. We are preparing. We are preparing for the real exam. That is the death. When death comes, we should be able to remember Krishna. That's it. No one else. We should not be remembering anything else in this material world. Just only remember Krishna at the time of death. That is possible only if we are able to remember Krishna now. This opportunity, we need to effectively use it. Fully train ourselves. We need to train. That is the main thing. We need to practice. Any exam, when we want to pass, we need to practice. Just like that, we prepare and go and write the exam, you are not going to pass it. So we need to practice. So that's what we need to practice, remembering Krishna. So if you practice remembering Krishna, if you remember Krishna all the time, so then we will definitely pass that exam. There is no doubt about it. There is simply no doubt. So that way, we know that our life is going to end. In that, there is no doubt. It's going to happen. But before our life comes to an end, we better prepare this exam. We need to better prepare. That's what is very important. Fully. 24/7, we should be able to fix our mind only on Krishna. So from this Bhagavad Gita, we understand everything about our mind, senses, intelligence, body, soul, everything we understand very well. And Krishna is teaching very, very clearly about how to control our mind. How to make our mind as our best friend. Krishna is teaching very nicely. So in the 6th chapter in the Dhyana Yoga, Krishna is teaching very, very nicely. Control our diet, control our food, control our sleep, control our activities. We need to regulate everything. So control our mind and then make our mind as our best friend. And then be peaceful. Enjoy. There is a real enjoyment. The real fun, the real happiness, the real enjoyment comes when our mind is not disturbed. When our mind just listens to us. When we are not attached or attracted to anything in this material world, then the real happiness comes. The real peace of mind comes, the real happiness comes. So at that point of time, we can simply focus fully on Krishna, not on anything in this material world. So that kind of opportunity has come to us by studying this Bhagavad Gita. We are studying this Bhagavad Gita, we are effectively making use of this opportunity and we are getting all the knowledge. So as I said in the beginning, we are understanding all the questions asked by Arjuna and we are understanding all the answers given by Krishna. So that way, if you repeatedly keep studying this Bhagavad Gita, we understand everything and we know that Krishna is the source of everything. Etat yonini bhutani sarvaniti upadarya aham krishnasya jagattaka prabhavaka pralayagastada. That's what Krishna is saying. So, Krishna is the source of both material and spiritual nature, everything. So, etat yonini bhutani sarvaniti upadarya aham krishnasya jagattaka prabhavaka pralayagastada. So, I am the source of creation, I am the source of annihilation. So, Krishna is the source of everything. Aham sarvasya prabhavo mattaka sarvam pravartate. So that knowledge we are getting from this Bhagavad Gita without any confusion, clearly. So our ignorance is going away. Our ignorance is dispelled. When we study this Bhagavad Gita, when we focus only on Krishna with the knowledge of this Bhagavad Gita, so we are, when we have this knowledge, so we will be able to actually focus our mind on Krishna. We will be able to serve Krishna. And Krishna is going to keep on giving us more and more opportunities to serve him. So that way, our life will become very, very meaningful life with this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. Otherwise, how can we can't even ask such questions about Kshetra, Kshetrajna, Jnana, Jnaya, Prakriti, Purusha, all such things. We cannot even think about such questions, which Arjuna asked. We cannot think about Brahma, Karma, Adhyatma, Adideva, Adibhuta, Adiyajna. Such questions itself we cannot even ask. But Arjuna asked. So, when Arjuna asked such very, very important questions. So, It's very, very important questions. So now we just need to study and understand these questions, and we need to understand all the answers and just practice in our life. That's it. So this chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra is a practice which we are supposed to do just based on only the 6th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. That's it. That is the way to control our mind, to make our mind as our best friend. So that way, if we are able to spend our daily life in chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra and preparing prasadam for Krishna, offering prasadam to Krishna. So like that, if we spend a lot of hours in doing such things, so then just go to work. That is for Krishna only. So that work, we should not get attached too much to the work. We should just work. In fact, even if you work 8 hours, we will be able to do much, much better actually. In fact, with attachment to the results, worrying about whether our job will be there or not, whether future, if you think about our future and start worrying, it's totally, we are actually wasting this life. There is no need to think about anything. If we love Krishna, if we depend on Krishna, then if we believe in Krishna, we really don't have to worry about our future. What is going to happen like that? We don't have to think about it at all. Then let Krishna think about it. Let Krishna focus. Let Krishna decide how we should live. He's not going to make us to live like a beggar. Krishna doesn't want to Krishna doesn't want to see us suffering in this material world. So that way, if we focus more and more on pleasing Krishna and serving Krishna, in our life, whatever we need, everything Krishna will provide. We will be able to actually experience. That's what is very important. Every devotee, every one of us, when we are actually following what Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, we will be able to experience how Krishna is taking care of our life. How Krishna is providing all the needs. It will just come on our way. Because everything is coming from Him only. Everything. Krishna is saying that I am giving the juice for all the vegetables and fruits. Somo bhutva rasatmaka. Gama visyacha bhutani dharayami aham ojasa pushnami chausadigi sarvaga somo bhutva rasatmaka. So I enter into each planet and by my energy they stay in orbit. And I give, as the moonlight, I give the juice to all the vegetables and fruits. And Krishna gives the rain. Tapami aham aham varsham. Tapami aham aham varsham nigrihnami utsurjamicha. I am the heat, I am the rain, I withhold and send forth. That's what Krishna is saying. So, in this material world, for the plants and vegetables and everything to grow, we need rain, we need sunlight. Krishna is saying that I am the Surya. Krishna is saying that. So, I am the sun. Prabhasmi sasi suryayo. So, that's what he is saying that. Prabhasmi sasi suryayo. So, I am the sasi means moon and surya means sun. So I am the light from the sun and the moon. And Krishna is saying that tapami aham aham varsham. So I am the varsham. I am the rain. So Krishna is the sun who is giving the sunlight. And Krishna is the rain. So that's why annad bhavanti bhutani parjanyad anna sambhavaga. So the living entities survive, subsist on grains. And the grains, they are produced by rains. Annat bhavanti bhutani parjanyat anna sambhavam. So rains are given by Krishna and sunlight is coming from Krishna and the juice for the vegetables and fruits and everything is also coming from the moonlight that is given by Krishna. So everything is supplied by Krishna. And then why we should actually think and worry that what will I do for my next bread, next meal, what will I do? No, we don't have to think about our daily bread at all. Krishna is supplying everything. We just have to fully remember Krishna, love Krishna and focus our mind on Krishna. So we need to just do that way only. So then Krishna's mercy, everything our life will be so beautiful. So that kind of opportunity has come to all of us with this Bhagavad Gita knowledge. When we study Bhagavad Gita, when we depend on Krishna, so that's what is going to happen. So by Krishna's causeless mercy, we are nicely studying. So we finished 26 slokas in the 13th chapter, and in the 25th and the 26th sloka, Krishna said that actually, Dhyanena Atmani Pasyanti Kechit Atmanam Atmanagam Anye Sankhyena Yogena Karma Yogena Chapare. So, by meditation, one can see the super soul, and others by the Sankhya Yoga and Karma Yoga. And then in the 26th Sloka, Krishna said that Anyetvevam Ajanantagar. So those who don't have this knowledge, so Shutvanyebhya Upasate. So just they will start worshipping by hearing about this. So Tepicha Atitarantyeva. So they will also surpass, they will also get out of this material world, transcend. Mrityum. Mrityum Shruti Parayanaga. Just because of the tendency to hear from others, so they will be Shruti Parayanaga. So because of that, Mrityum, this path of death, they will be liberated from this path of death. That's what Krishna is saying. So now in the next sloka, sloka number 27, Krishna is teaching us there. Yavat sanjayate kinchit satvam stavara jangamam kshetra kshetra jnasam yoga tadviddi varatarshabam. Yavat sanjayate kinchit. So whatever is produced. Sanjayate means produced. So both moving and non-moving. Stavaram. Stavaram means immovable things. So that's what is stavaram. So we study in the botany as stavara veal. So stavaram. So it is in the Tamil I'm talking about. So it is stavaram. So means it's immovable. So stavaram, stavara jangamam. So jangamam means it's moving, movable. So anything in this world, whatever we see, it is movable or immovable, everything. Yavat sanjayate kinchit satvam stavara jangamam kshetra kshetrajna samyogat. So they are all the combination of this kshetra and kshetrajna. We studied at length that 24 elements of material nature, mahabhutani ahankara buddhi avyaktam evacha indriyani dasa ekamcha panchai chendriya gocharak. We studied about it. So they are all kshetra. So then Icha Dvesaga, so Sukha Dukkha, all such things we studied. Sangataka Kshetra Adriti, Etat Kshetram Samasenam. So all those things are Kshetra. Then Kshetrajna is the one that is one who knows about the Kshetra. So basically the soul is the Kshetrajna. So that's why in this material world, everything is only Kshetra and Kshetrajna, combination of whatever we see, anything. Yavat sanjayate kinchit, whatever is produced in this world, whatever comes into being, whatever is produced, whatever comes into existence in this world, it's simply a combination of kshetra kshetrajna samyogat tadviddhi bharatasya. What a great knowledge Krishna has given to us. Now we know about this world. We know what this world is about. We know about the panjabhutas. We know about the mahabhuta, basically the five great elements, earth, water, fire, air and space. And we know about the minds and intelligence and ahankara. And we know about soul, all such things. And all the so-called great scientists and all, they are only dealing with this one only. Nothing more than that. So only it's all everything based on the physics, chemistry and everything. Most of our science developed only in the last century actually. So much of knowledge even in this Panjabhuta Mahabhuta, we got only in the last century. So that way, Krishna has given this same knowledge, this knowledge actually even about the Mahabhuta 5,000 years ago in Bhagavad Gita. So that way, this Bhagavad Gita is the king of knowledge. It is the source of knowledge, king of knowledge, the most confidential knowledge, the purest knowledge, and it can be joyfully performed. So we have got an opportunity to study this knowledge, which we should fully make use of it. That's what is very, very important. So kshetra kshetrajna samyoga tadviddhi paratasava. Now, knowing that we are not the body, we are the soul, we need to do everything good for our soul. That's what is very important. So with this knowledge, we need to act. So that means this human life is very precious. We cannot simply waste this life. And we need to effectively make use of the time in so that our soul can get freed from the modes of nature. That should be our goal. Our soul means us. We should get freed from the modes of nature. We cannot even, if we say our soul, my soul, your soul, that doesn't even make sense. It is only I or you. So there is the soul. So the soul, I should get freed, you should get freed. So we all should get freed from the modes of material nature with this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. So by Krishna's causeless mercy, we have successfully finished the sloka number 27 today in the 13th chapter. Hare Krishna, I will stop now and we will discuss if any questions are there. Hare Krishna.